our first determinant is have a plan for the future. One way to like kind of direct your plan and guide your plan is to either have a social media campaign or use social media to kind of learn about your, like use social media as a tool to like gain information and I just reach out to people and organizations to learn more and learn the latest on prevention methods and tools to help yourself stay informed and up to date on the newest and safest prevention tools.
Okay, so our second determinant was being vaccinated. And one of the ways we thought we could stop the spread of STD is being vaccinated. And some of the STDs that can be prevented by taking a vaccine before sexual contact include HPV, which is human papillomavirus, hepatitis A and B. And the vaccines work by not letting the virus spread throughout the body, so it won't limit its effects or not have any. And doctors should be required to inform all teens at all checkups they go to, and they should also, and we thought they should also try to make an effort to spread the information online or in schools.
Our third determinant is being informed. We want to require an informative course in high school that is more in depth and takes more time to cover the topic and teach about the STD, the causes, effects, prevention, and more to be able to effectively educate teens.
Our fourth determinant, advocating condom use. We're going to use a wellness class to properly inform people on condom use.
Our best solution is getting informed. This is our best because it fully covers the topic and goes more in depth by being able to have a class just for it. And because STD is a major health problem affecting developing countries and also countries that are developed, by having this course, it will help students by being knowledgeable and help them with their future decisions. And also, which hopefully in the end will lower the risk and percentage of teens affected.
So our non-impact determinants. So the first one was abstinence. We thought we couldn't control that because we felt it would be hard to change like a person's morals or beliefs, like what they believe is like the right way for them. And then reducing partners and frequency of sex. We thought it would be hard to control that because it would just be challenging to control like who and like when a person like is participating in sex. And then being involved in the community, we thought that one would be hard to control. Just like the other one, it would just be hard to like control like what the person values and like what they think is important, like getting involved. Like we just thought that would be hard to control.
Prevention methods. The best is abstinence because it's the only 100% way of not getting an STD. Our second is both you and your partner get tested, therefore you guys know if or any possible infections you or your partner may have. And third is use of condom. Though it doesn't protect you 100%, it's the best and much safer choice than being unprotected.
So our action steps. So the first one to stopping the spread of STDs we thought was using the barrier method. Which the best method is condoms for that method. And then if used correctly, condoms can prevent partners from spreading and receiving STDs that could be spread through intercourse. And we found that to be 98% effective. And then the next step is getting tested regularly. It's good to get on a regular schedule, going to the doctor and getting tested for any STDs. And that makes you more informed so you won't pass it on to anyone, and it makes the treatment come faster if you know that you have the STD.
We have two apps and they're both free. The first one is STD Guide. It serves as a quick reference for doctors and related parties on identification and treatment for STDs. And our next one is STD Triage Ask a Dermatologist. It anonymously connects you to a board-certified dermatologist in just under 24 hours. It is easy to use. All you have to do is download the app, take a picture of your affected skin problems such as rash, bumps, redness, or other things, and submit your questions, and you will receive a personalized answer from your dermatologist, which contains medical information, what it most likely is, whether it is treatable, and whether or not you should see that dermatologist or a doctor in person for more tests. And then some programs. Science and Success identifies evaluated programs throughout the U.S. proven to reduce teen STDs and cause two beneficial changes in sexual risk behavior. 14 of them, or there are 26 U.S.-based programs for these teens, and 14 increases condom use. 14 of these programs help delay time of first sex. 13 show reductions in number of partners. 7 reduce frequency of sex, and 10 help reduce unprotected sex.
All right, so our organizations that are help combating STDs around the world, we have 3 of them kind of on a global, national, and more local scale. The one that's probably helping the global scale the most is the World Health Organization. And they just by bringing education, vaccines to like third world countries to help spot what I talked about earlier, like the, how 6 countries take about 1/2. And the STDA, the American Sexually Transmitted Disease Association, their own mission statement says they're dedicated to the control and study of STDs, and it's free for anybody to join. The federal and state governments, you know, this is kind of a weirder one, but these really make the difference because they can provide legislation, and they're the things that fund and sponsor programs to stop the spread of STDs.
So, we have our Jeopardy game. So the winning team will get another table.